Minecraft has a problem. The frame rate. This is a problem so deeply rooted in Minecraft's history that it's become a joke unto itself at this point. If you've played Minecraft Java Edition within the past decade, there's a solid chance that you've run into frame rate issues somewhere along the way. Minecraft 1.18 addressed this issue by making the game's performance more consistent. However, the new terrain generation means that what we ultimately got was a more consistent but still lower frame rate. Ultimately, the point is, Minecraft is an 11-year-old game. Its development history is long and complicated. It's got frame rate issues, but we do the best we can with what we have. Geez, I make it sound like Mojang is starving us here. But no, quite the opposite actually. Minecraft isn't just a game as is released by Mojang. It's also a game with a thriving mod community. Talented individuals and even entire teams of people still create mods that add a wide variety of different content to the game. And some of those individuals literally grew up with Minecraft, meaning they know a lot about it. As time has gone by, however, I've noticed that the modding scene for performance-based improvements have really been taking off lately. If you play Minecraft Java and happen to use the OptiFine mod for performance right now, but nothing else, well, let me put this in simple terms. On my machine, in this world, with all chunks loaded at a render distance of 16, with all other settings being default aside from the frame rate cap being disabled, in full screen 1440p resolution, Minecraft runs around 145 frames per second while standing still. I'm not complaining, as my machine is pretty overpowered. However, using the OptiFine mod with the same configuration, I get around 270 frames per second, an obviously crazy improvement in its own right, but with the mod combination that I'll be showing off today, I get over 500 frames per second. That is honestly mental. These kinds of performance gains provide a lot of breathing room for you to increase your own in-game settings, including but not limited to increasing your render distance, which makes 1.18's landscape much more enjoyable to look at. While improving your frame rate will be the primary focus of this video, I've gotta tell you, when I learned about the sheer variety of 1.18 mods that also focus on quality of life improvements, I went a little bit overboard creating my ideal Minecraft experience, an improved F3 menu, an actually good in-game friends list, in-game account switching, and even fully featured configurable shaders. Whether you're here for the frame rate improvements, quality of life improvements, or anything in between and beyond, let's go ahead and let's get right into it. Big thanks to World of Tanks for sponsoring this video. World of Tanks is a free-to-play multiplayer game where you can choose between more than 600 different tank varieties to take onto the battlefield, which put a focus on historical accuracy that give these tanks an authentic look and feel. Drive your tanks across open fields, deserts, forests, and more as you play your matches in one of over 40 different battle arenas. Earn experience as you play to upgrade and modify your tanks with a wide array of different offensive and defensive add-ons. Download World of Tanks via the first link in the description down below. If you use code TANKMANIA, you'll get a 7-day premium account, 250,000 credits, a premium tank Excelsior, and 3 rental tanks for 10 battles each. The promo code is for any and all new players, so if you're interested, be sure to grab these perks before they're gone. Much appreciation and thanks to World of Tanks for sponsoring this video. The series of events that ultimately led to me discovering these mods is a story that I feel is worth telling, so that's how this video will be structured. I'll still be covering each mod one by one, but I have a story to tell as to why I went looking for them, and then I'll talk about what they do and why I enjoy them. If you just want the list of mods and nothing else, check out the description down below. So let's begin. Back in October, I made a video titled I've Fallen in Love with Minecraft 1.18, where I heavily weighed in on how I felt about the visual experience of the update. For as magnificent as 1.18's terrain generation is, the increased height limit alongside the new terrain generation means that 1.18 is a rather difficult version of Minecraft to run, even on really good hardware. That's problem number one. Problem number two is that, in my opinion, Minecraft 1.18's visual appeal cannot be fully appreciated on the game's default render distance of 12 chunks. There's just not enough terrain loaded at once to really appreciate it. Throughout making that video, I usually kept the render distance between 20 and 24 and tried to be careful as to not capture footage that was too laggy. However, if you look closely enough throughout a lot of the video, you can see that I was usually getting only like 20 to 30 frames per second, which was never gonna cut it in the long run. In the videos that I made following that one, I began playing around with the replay mod because Minecraft's in-game unmodified camera system just doesn't feel adequate anymore. We recently published a video all about the replay mod and a whole suite of other content creation mods, so be sure to check out that video if you're interested. However, deciding to use the replay mod ultimately led me to problems 3 and 4. The third problem is that the replay mod requires the fabric mod loader, which my previous performance mod of choice, the OptiFine mod, is not compatible with. I know that the OptiFabric mod is a thing, but the OptiFine mod was already being pretty temperamental with MultiMC, which is my game launcher of choice over the vanilla launcher. That's problem number 4. Before continuing, however, I want to make clear that I have enormous respect for SP614X, who created the OptiFine mod and has kept it up to date for all of these years. I mean, absolutely no disrespect with this video, but when it comes to matters such as this, I do go with the option that works best for me. And these days, in my opinion, the crown for Minecraft performance mods goes to the Sodium mod and also the Iris mod. The two primary mods that I've chosen to replace the OptiFine mod are called Sodium and Iris. The Sodium mod drastically improves vanilla Minecraft's performance by nearly an order of magnitude. There's also the Lithium mod and the Phosphor mod as well, which respectfully improve server and lighting performance. Sodium, Lithium, and Phosphor are all authored by the same person, Jelly Squid, so they're all very likely to always work with each other, which is why I've only really counted this as one mod. There also exists a fork of the Sodium mod that enables the replay mod's option to render your scenes out into a video file. If you're interested in having that functionality, there you go. That's how you do it. Secondly, there's the Iris mod, which allows for me to use shaders with the Sodium mod. Up until recently, the Iris mod actually did not allow for you to configure any of your shader options, which I know would be a deal breaker for a lot of you. However, this mod's 1.2 update, which was released in mid-January, fixed that very problem. So, cool. The way in which I found out about these mods is actually pretty simple. I followed the Minecraft speedrunning scene for as long as it has existed, and quite a long time ago, I noticed that Minecraft speedrun.com moderators began to allow the use of Sodium, while also disallowing the use of the OptiFine mod. However, I didn't actually make the switch to the Sodium mod until very recently, when I found out about the Iris mod as well. While working on the video titled "I Broke Every Minecraft Setting," I was really quite annoyed by how bad Minecraft's performance was with just the replay mod. This led me to looking for a solution that used the fabric mod loader and was also compatible with the replay mod. It was actually within this very clip within that video that I first noticed just how incredible the Sodium and Iris mod were, and I've never looked back. The mods that I just covered make up the foundation for my ideal Minecraft experience. However, there also exist a few issues that I have with the vanilla Minecraft experience beyond just its performance, so for that, let's move on to talking about a few mods that I enjoy that further improve my quality of life. Before diving on in, I want to make clear that this is just my list of preferred mods at the present moment. If you have a set of mods that you prefer using, great. I'm glad that you're happy with them. However, I understand that many of you may find my list entirely incomplete, or you may even disagree with some of my choices. I enjoy the vanilla Minecraft experience, and I don't wish to add any mods that add actual content to the game. Instead, I want the vanilla experience to be as optimized as possible, alongside adding features that help me as a content creator.
There we go, we are fully optimized.
Another thing to consider is, I'm a survival mode purist. If I'm playing on survival mode in a solo environment, I don't like to use the F3 menu for coordinate tracking. You know what? The F3 menu in Minecraft 1.18 is a mess. The fact that Mojang have yet to give us the option to disable individual items within this monstrosity is kind of a joke. This leads us nicely into my first quality of life mod, the Better F3 mod, which fixes this exact problem. The Better F3 mod splits the F3 menu into distinct sections that you can freely toggle on or off, resize at will, and it also allows for you to adjust a few colors within each section. The configuration that you see right now is what I have it set to for myself on a day-to-day basis. You may be curious as to why my F3 menu is multiple lines away from the top of the screen, and that's so it can fit around my live streaming template, because getting back into live streaming is on my radar right now. Did anybody say Ant Farm Survival Live? Twitch.tv/AntVenom. Anyways, I still like having a lot of information within my F3 menu, just not that much. Before getting into the last major mod that I have for this list, let's go over a few smaller mods that really don't require a lot of explaining. First is a mod called FPS Monitor that allows for me to have my frame rate, memory usage, and server ping on the top left of my screen when the F3 menu is closed, to which I only ever really have the frame rate itself enabled. However, this mod also does something kind of genius. It adds these three items to the menu bar for your game, so you don't even need to have them on screen at all while the game is in windowed mode, which I like a lot. Next up is the Mod Menu mod, which brings functionality similar to Forge's Mod Menu to Fabric Mods. This makes it way easier to configure the mods that you have installed. Next up is a mod called Raised, which gets rid of this absolutely stupid bug where the hotbar is cut off by one pixel on the bottom of the screen within the vanilla game. Have you ever noticed this before? Well, if not, you can't unsee it now. Mojang, could you please fix this one already? Why do I need a mod for this? Anyways, at this point, there's only one mod left, and it is a personal favorite of mine. But first, if you want to download any of these mods for yourself, I'd highly recommend finding them over on Modrinth or CurseForge, with Modrinth currently becoming the more popular option within modern times, so far as I can tell. This list will be ever expanding, so if I ever add any major mods worth noting to my own setup even after this video releases, I'll try to edit that information into the description down below. So, last but certainly not least, is the Essential mod. Full disclosure, I have a financial connection with the Essential mod in the form of a custom partner cosmetic wherein I get a portion of each sale. It's a full body ant suit because why not? And it can be worn and seen in game by anybody else using the Essential mod who have cosmetics enabled, which is toggleable. However, I approached them for this partnership because I do genuinely think that this mod has many must-have features for Minecraft. First off, this is the mod that provides an in-game friends list and messaging system to the game. On top of that, you can just click a button within Minecraft's menu with this mod installed to invite your friends to a server that the Essential mod just makes. No downloading the server jar or configuring a server manually required. The Essential mod just handles it all. If you have multiple accounts, as I do for the purposes of filmmaking, you may find that you're logged into the wrong account at times and want to be able to change accounts without having to exit the game at all. Well, the Essential mod has you covered there as well, providing the means to log into multiple accounts within a single play session. Beyond that, There are free and paid cosmetics within the Essential mod, as I previously mentioned. Many of these cosmetics support various causes and creators, so if you want to look like a giant ant, because, I mean, come on, you know, then you can check that one out as well. Last up for real this time is a website called VanillaTweaks that I wanted to mention. I'm not personally using any of these items myself at this time, however, VanillaTweaks offer a pretty neat variety of data packs, crafting tweaks, and resource pack tweaks that all aim to provide similar quality of life improvements to the game, but not in a way that requires mods. Links, as always, will be in the description down below. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing for more, as that just about does it for me for now. My list of mods that I personally use is ever evolving based on my desires at any given time, so to create your ideal setup, consider giving some of these a try as well, or find a set of mods that works for you. Links as always down below. So I hope you all enjoyed. My name is AntVenom, and I bid you all farewell. Thanks so much for watching.